Moving on to that now.
I'll look at that on the left. What about the left and the left?
Thank you.
so the students are not yet here. Yes, you are looking for a room?
No, I put room for the next one.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Thank you. Because
In the context where you are going to be given by your reporter, or the headline that your reporter is going to write, it's not going to be the one that is going to be placed. You might have changed. So I wanted to go through like headline writing. How, what some of the things that we have to be looking into when we are have to write a good headline. And in this case, say a headline is taken as it's a line or collection of lines of display type that precedes a news story. Right? And summarize it. So, the definition that is here, although it's not limited to the definition, is a line, a headline is a line or collection of lines of display, right? Of display type. So, I think we're trying to be more, it's the language of the designer, right? So, display type, we know. We're talking about this character that we use, right? So, lines of display type, right? That precedes the news story and summarizes it. So, this one, I think, is making more sense when you understand what it's talking about. Line or the collection of lines of display type, right? That precedes the news story and summarizes it, right? So, usually, as we know that if you have seen a newspaper, especially that you have seen newspapers before, if you go in the street, you find that some newspapers are going to be selling out. I know I put it in Malawi, we don't have that much time to sell some newspapers. We are in a scenario where we only have those papers. There are only two papers, eh? Daily Times, Malawi. Let me say, VNA papers. And the newspapers. They are no easy answer. So people are going to buy. Had it been that in that moment, you still know that the BNL papers and the nation papers are going to be the ones that are going to be maybe marketable, because they have been in the industry for a while, they have been practicing how to write new headlines. There are people who have been in this news writing game for a while. So they know the tricks. Of how we're trying to learn to use headlines, a good headline. So, usually, as in features, because we talked about feature writing, and we talked about which is what is straightforward news writing. Straightforward news writing, or straightforward news, are the ones that we see in this daily papers, the front page papers. Usually, they are political stories, and the stories that are affects the public, the nation. So usually are those stories whereby the writer, doesn't have that liberty to maybe to be much more creative as opposed to features, let me just say. Because features, we talked about a hard news story. This is a soft news story, right? So, features are soft news stories. Well, what we mean by that are those stories that people read them in their free time, most of the time, and it doesn't have time, most of the time, they might not be that claim was the picture. Or maybe they might think that the time that will not exhaust, will not become stale in a very short space. There will be a story that even if you read it after 1 week, will make sense, you know? Suddenly. That's why people do not usually rush to read pictures. Because they know, I can read it maybe during the weekend, I can read it any time, it will still be a big picture. How do you store that? Well, the ones that you know. We have no usual containing developing stories. They contain those hard breaking news, you know, whereby if you don't read it today, by tomorrow the story would have changed the angle, right? Which means you go to make sure that you know what is happening right now. So usually there's much more flexibility in the features, whereby even the style of writing the features. In a straightforward news, you are going to find that he invented the pillar in his time, right? Whereby you have what is called a lead, the first paragraph. Right? You are going to find that he was already talked about the five W's and H. So straightforward news are going to immediately after page 5, they are going to be answering the 5 W's and H. They are not going to be the part about the push by maybe talking about one or two things. Instead, they are going to be the page 5. When you read the page 5, you know what has happened. You know who is involved. You know not all the time they are doing the page, but you know access to the page. As you go to the second paragraph, you know your answer. While in the pictures, they might follow that approach where it's a pyramid approach. Right? You start from the beginning, right? Play around with the first paragraph, then the third, then the answer to these questions. Second paragraph. So, because of that, when you talk about pyramid writing, it's more, much more than the level of creative writing, whereby the headline usually is not that's clear, let me say. You are for that debate to play around with the figure of speech somehow. While usually, instead of news, you usually make sure that when the people read the story, they should have something that is going to tell them about the story, right? Which is clear. But we were also going to prevent that the element of creativity is going to be found in the order that we use the element, but not much. The style that is usually followed in straightforward news is what is called bad, right? You have to fit a figure of speech where you can say, I am a, you know, you are being a project, where you are calling somebody who is a poor person, you are calling a poor person a king. That is being like, that's a very, isn't it? But in fact, it would be something like, you know, you're playing around with your limits, like I gave an example of Pete Shawinka. It's one of the very players. Yeah? Now, we hear that she's not going to be given her money. So the headline went like, "No, there is no peace for Jawaika." But her name is Peace Jawaika. So you can see that the peace in the headline is not for the name, but it's for what has happened. But the Jawaika is for the name, but it has also went well with her name. So that is the fact. Whereby you are being creative with the headline. By using maybe a certain relationship with them and them, but in a creative way, but it will make sense, people will understand what you're talking about. So you see, instead of what you use, you want to find something like that, but not in this instance, like whereby you want to be there, you might have a headline that you have to read the whole story to make sense of the headline. But in that kind of case, you are not usually going to find it, instead of what you use. So that's what I wanted to say. But I said that it's still a skill in writing in general, because you don't just write anyhow. So when we look at the nature of headlines, usually most of the headlines that we still use for it, they hear more about headline captures. Hard news story. Usually, if you have one is called a hard news story, one person is called opposite hard news story. It's like you have a picture, then there is a caption. I think you know when you say caption, right? When you have a picture, you know, that is those words that write about the picture. So, a main line in the honeydew story is like a caption over the story, right? It will point you, say something about what is happening in the story. That's why you also headlines are going to act as a summary, because we were going to
I believe you know lazy, right?
What are you talking about? Lazy, you know what I'm saying? Because you say lazy, someone will say it's a festive paragraph of the story, right? Like it's, that's where you read it. The festive paragraph. Go ahead and say